Hi guys, my name is Kiva and this is DIY with KB. So I spend so much time telling you about the little modifications that I make to my home, but I kind of wanted to explain why I do them. So in today's video, I'm going to give you my top tips on how to make your home look luxurious. Before we get into today's video, if you like me, my content, or Wiener, the dog, be sure to subscribe to my channel, like this video, and check me out on Instagram at kiva.bren. Now let's get into today's video. Before I give you any of my top tips, I do want to say one thing. The whole point of my channel for me is to let you know that regardless of your budget, regardless of what your house looks like, I believe that everyone deserves to have a beautiful home. So I'm telling you how to make your home look luxurious, and that could be if you spent $500,000 on your home or if you're paying rent somewhere. You can do all of these things, it's just going to be on a different scale. So one of my suggestions is going to be get an ornate mirror. Of course, you don't need to get the same 9-foot mirror that I have. You could get one that's 5 feet tall or something like that. It's all about style and what those things add to a space. So bear with me, even if you don't feel like you have a space that can be made to look luxurious, trust me, you can do it. So in my opinion, the number one way to make your house look the most luxurious, this is number one for a reason, is a huge statement mirror like this one. Okay, you're like, Kiva, what are you talking about? It doesn't have to be 9 feet tall like this one. I'm not saying that, but a statement mirror that has some texture, it's ornate, and it has like a color where you're just like, ugh, is it. I'm telling you guys. When we first got this mirror, I'm telling you, I was out here showing out. I would leave our front door open and our neighbors would walk past and they'd be like, oh, what's that? And I'd be like, oh, you can come in. As if I wasn't sitting there waiting for them to want to come in. Also, a really good thing about an oversized mirror is that it reflects stuff, right? Because that's like the point of a mirror, but it reflects light. So even if your space is small, it's going to make it look larger when you have your windows open or you have a light on. And that's exactly what we want, because luxury is associated with largeness, at least in terms of size of a home. So no, you don't have to add this statement mirror. It is expensive and you don't need to spend that much money on it. You can get a statement mirror from pretty much anywhere. I really love nice gilded mirrors like this one, because it's adding that brass and something that's really ornate without me having to put in any effort, right? I haven't styled this mirror. You just put it on the wall and that's it. It's the easiest way to do something because you don't really need to have any source of creativity, which a lot of us want. I know people, you know, there's a lot of controversy about this, but it's okay if you don't have like an interior design, like sense of intuition. It's okay if you're not creative. You can still want your home to be beautiful and not like have those skills. So this is a really easy way to do it with very minimal effort. This is the Louis Philippe gilt mirror from Restoration Hardware. It's super expensive. You definitely don't need to have this one. You don't need to invest that amount of money. A more affordable option is the Primrose mirror from Anthropology. I love that mirror. It's so cute, but I will say it's pretty feminine. So I'm not gonna recommend it if like you or whoever you're living with wants something a little bit more masculine or neutral. If you do get that one, get it in black. But if you don't like that one, there are options everywhere. The next way to make your home look luxurious without having to put in too much effort is to go with oversized vessels. So, you know, your girl is really into vessels right now for absolutely no reason. I bought like 100 vessels last month. I don't have anywhere to put them. I don't have any use for them, but I love them. So this is a great example. Look at me, I'm hidden behind here. This is a great example. This is a vessel from West Elm, and it's really nice and simple, and because it's so oversized, I don't really have to do much with it, especially since I try to go like minimal and modern, but even if you didn't have that sort of space, it can really stand on its own. And the other way to make it look more luxurious is not only to just have like an oversized vessel, but to put some type of greenery or plant or something in here. These are actually faux branches from Michaels. You could put real branches. Put some branches in here and this stands alone. This sits on the coffee table by itself. It's a statement. My guests like it and that's it. I feel like minimalism or just like an oversized vessel helps space be taken up without looking empty. Again, luxury, you gotta think intentionally empty. You have to have intention with every single thing that you put in your home, but it has to look right. So this is something that I did. I have a whole slew of vessels that I purchased. I bought them all at the same time. Again, I always match them together in the store to make sure that they go together. And this could just be like a table full of vessels and that would be like an entire moment. But that is a great way to do things. Right now, what's really in is you get an oversized vessel. So best place to get those, again, is at home. They have a great garden section. The colors are hideous. I mean, they're truly abysmal, but you can spray paint them because, you know, we all got spray paint and you can put greenery in them. Athena Calderon, she like really started this trend, I think, where you get like this oversized vase and you put like a single branch in it and you're like, yeah, I did that. And you do that like on your kitchen or your dining table or wherever. So that's what's in right now. So that's what I would suggest you to do. It just looks nice and luxurious. And again, less is more. So that's kind of what we're running with here. If you don't want to spend too much money at like at home or something like that, the most affordable way to do it is to go to Goodwill or some type of consignment shop or thrift store and buy something there and just paint over it. Just make sure that you have the right paint to do stuff like that. Spray paint is really good because it can cling to pretty much anything, or you're gonna have to prime something. But that's a really easy way to do things. But sometimes vessels can be on sale. Like right now, it's the holiday season, so things are like super duper on sale. So sometimes it's like cheaper to buy it from a store than a Goodwill because you're gonna get the color that you want. But these are from West Elm. West Elm has really great vessels right now because they're all really black and white and really like modern abstract shapes. I'm also really into Urban Outfitters right now. I haven't updated Babe about that, but they have such good things. I tried to like order a bed the other day and I was like, I don't need a bed. But anyway, they also have really good vessels, so try there. So tip number three, I'm gonna be a huge hypocrite right now because you can see me here sitting in front of this big painting. And I'm about to tell you that the best way to make another way to make your home look luxurious is to have framed art. And of course, the biggest piece of art in my home is not framed. So I'm gonna get you a canvas right now. I'm gonna show it to you, and then I'm gonna show you something else with a frame in it, and you're gonna be like, ooh la la, that really did it for me. And I'm gonna be right, so let's do that. Okay guys, you know, we're filming as we think and I never stop thinking. So I think the one reason we also got away with not framing this is because it's huge. So either you can go massive art and not have it framed, or you do something smaller and you keep it in a frame. These are not the examples for you. So let me get you some other art. So this is a painting that I did for the entryway. And I think it works really well because we have a set of art, but if this were in a frame, I think it would take it to the very next level. So this piece of artwork, we did it, and I think it would be fine without a frame, like just stretched on a canvas, but I feel like once we put it in this frame, it really took it to the very next level, because a frame is an anchor for artwork, you know what I mean? And then a frame to me says, I did this art and I'm confident about it and I like it so much that I'll frame it. Because once you put something in a frame, you're not gonna paint over it again. But a frame really takes it to the next level. You can do a really nice, simple frame if you're going for something a little bit more minimal, or you can do something ornate like this. So this was originally gold and I painted it black. And I'm here for it. I know a lot of you get your art from Home Goods, so what you do, you can get that art from Home Goods, then get a piece of wood, much like this one. Yeah, I'm working on a project, you know I am. And you just cut it down, you do your 45 degree angles, and you make a frame, and you just hammer it into your Home Goods painting because there's wood supports in there, paint it, and then you have a frame. So you got that art that was only $70, and you got a frame that you made for $4, and then it's gonna look so much better. I have picture lights on almost all of my paintings that I can reach. Of course, the one over there, there's no picture light because I can't get up there, neither can Babe. If you can get up there, you're welcome to come in here and install one for me. But picture lights also really anchor a painting because you're like, I'm so confident about this painting that I'm gonna put it here. Also, Babe, okay, so this is gonna sound really silly, but we were watching Scandal recently and she was like, did you notice that every single painting in the fake White House has a picture light above it? Think about that, in museums, in nice houses, everywhere, there's always a picture light anchoring something, and that's exactly what we do in our home, and they're really affordable. You can get battery-powered ones. This one's from Restoration Hardware, and we just got it because of the outlet, because these things are expensive for no reason. Okay, so this is our entryway artwork, and again, I feel like this works because it's a set and they're not framed, but again, to make it look more like for real, I put a picture light on them and it anchors it really well, so when you walk in the hallway, it feels like the hallway is full, but there is no furniture. And you guys have been asking me about this art forever, so a tutorial, it's all crooked, you're just showing them this.
No,
with
this
all
one's
this
so
crooked? What is wrong with you? Guys, I tell you, I appreciate my videographer because she's free, because we're married. I don't know what to do here, but she just lets me film looking wild. I'll have like paint running down my back and she'll be like, babe, you look great. But anyway, I'll fix this. But the video showing you how to do this art is going up on Friday. I'm gonna show you how to do several different types of art, even that bathroom artwork. So stay tuned for that. But yeah, the picture light on here just makes it look incredible. And this picture light is battery powered. It's from Amazon. It's really inexpensive and it's easy to put up. There's a built-in level. The very last thing that is going to make your home look luxurious is a rug. So you're saying, Kiva, don't I already have a rug? I hope that you do. But a rug really, again, anchors the space. You want a rug that's going to tie in all your colors. So I'll sit down. A rug either needs to tie in all your colors and have all of them in there, or your rug can be your accent piece. So I never go with the accent piece. I've tried, but then I always am very uncomfortable with that decision. So with this rug, we got it from PA World of Rugs. Shout out to James. James is our neighbor. And he was incredible because Babe and I are super indecisive. So we were like, we want this. And so he just sent us a million pictures. And then there was the one. So we just went and picked it up.
I like this rug. It's nice and thick, like wool material. Our dog also enjoys it. And we actually put a pad, which I feel like makes it look way better in the space because it doesn't move around. And that's what the guy at the rug store told us, that you need a rug pad to like maintain a nice rug.
Yeah, it was like $200 extra. And we were like, as if we weren't spending a lot of money on the rug in the first place. It's always like that. It's like when you're like buying something online and you've spent $500, but they're like $10 shipping and you're like, oh, I just don't know about that. So that's how it was with the rug. But we really like this rug because the lines, so there's a dark gray rectangle and then the outside is light gray, and the lines line up directly with our sofa, so it's exactly 8 feet. So it really tells you exactly where the sofas are supposed to be. So everything is really linear and they're clean lines, and I love that. So that's what we went with a rug over here. And we have gray in our house, we have dark gray, so it just brings it all together. It doesn't add anything else, it doesn't detract from what we've already been doing, it's kind of enhancing it. The rug, again, it's just going to unify everything. It's going to cover up the floor because it's very rare that we have like a floor color that perfectly matches the aesthetic we go with, unless you're building a house like fresh and new and you know exactly what you want. But again, you just want the whole space to flow, and the rug allows you to do that, and therefore it's gonna look luxurious. Cohesion and luxury go hand in hand. On the other hand, this rug is actually from At Home, and it's like a fake like oriental rug. There's a medallion in the middle and it has the ivory and it's not too yellow. It looks yellow right now just because of the light we have in our house, but it's actually not yellow, which I love. It's a true ivory. And it kind of just makes like the chairs look continuous with the floor, which I like. Again, it's all about having the whole room flow. Flow. A rug just kind of like brings like parts of the room together, and it also helps divide the room. So that side of the room has a lot of gray in it because of the coffee table and my artwork. So this rug and the media console and everything, this is all gray. But over here, you just really have ivory and black. So it brings in some of the gray that's over there, but it's mostly just ivory making this pop. So it also just really helps separate the two rooms, because when there's no rug, it's kind of just like one continuous room, and it doesn't, so. Let me also say this, obviously open floor plans are really exciting now, but an open floor plan also doesn't look as if like you have as many rooms. But this helps to divide the rooms and make it seem like you can separate your space, and that you do have different rooms. So those are my top tips on how to make your home look luxurious. Those are tips that I swear by. I'm confident about those tips, I'm telling you. And it's not just about making your house look luxurious, it's also about making your house look cohesive, because that's the most important thing. I think everybody is really good at organizing one space. You can style one console table, or you can make one room look great. But how do we figure out how to make our whole entire house look uniform, but with each space having its own little twist? So these tips should help you accomplish that goal. Down below, I will put links to the mirrors and the picture lights and all of those things so that you can add them to your home and make it look a little bit more refined. If you liked today's video, please remember to subscribe to my channel, like this video, and check me out on Instagram @kiva.brent. Thank you so much for watching, and until next time, have a beautiful day.